The University of Pangasinan is 97 years old, and you have chosen to include the church in your celebration. Modesty aside, but with great gratitude, I have to tell you, my dear students, that in the surveys conducted among students, two institutions are most credible for young people. The first institution is the school, and the second institution is the church. Why is it that church and school are credible for people? Because church and school are caretakers of a very important treasure. And what is it? Truth. The business of school is formation in truth, and the mission of the church is proclamation of the truth. We need schools and we need the church because we need the truth. But truth in its proclamation goes through a step-by-step process before it becomes consoling and liberating. First, the proclamation of truth is always, my dear students, it is always confrontational. In other words, you cannot proclaim the truth and be pleasant and be goody-goody with everybody. Because if you want to be a proclaimer of the truth, a teacher of the truth, you have to be ready to have enemies, to have people who will treat you as enemies even if you do not treat them as enemies. Because liars will always get angry at those who proclaim the truth. But truth is always confrontational. But the confrontation of truth is not for conflict. The confrontation of truth is not to create animosity. No. The confrontation of truth leads to the second C. And what is the second C of truth? Challenge. In other words, we shake the truth because we want liars to change. In other words, we proclaim the truth because we want the trolls to be converted. We proclaim the truth because we know that liars will go to hell, and we want to save them from hell. That is why we challenge them to be truth tellers. Only after challenging, and if they respond with the third C, which is conversion, then truth becomes liberating. So the University of Pangasinan is a truth teacher. It is a truth seedbed. It is a truth farm. And at the University of Pangasinan, we pursue truths. We preserve truths. And we transmit truths. We do not create other truths. Because when we create truths, most likely they are creatures of liars. We do not create alternative truths, because truths are immutable, truths are constant, and truths have been there even before the creation of the world. So truth is confrontational, and truth challenges the liars to change. And when liars change, and when trolls stop earning from lying, then the truth teller must rejoice. The truth teller must celebrate, because you have won over a liar to the side of truth. And then the fourth mission of a Catholic school, of the Catholic Church, and then the university, is this. When we seek conversion, then we must always offer the fourth C, consolation. And Dietrich Bonhoeffer said, The church should not be a giver of cheap grace. And the university must not be a factory of cheap diplomas. Because you, my dear students, you grow best, not from an easy life. Because comfort and ease are very bad teachers. Comfort and ease teach you wrong lessons in life. It is when you are tested. It is when you are humiliated. It is when you endure sufferings that you learn best and you deepen your character and you become better persons. So, do not curse your professors for giving you difficult assignments. Those difficult assignments make you better because we don't like you to be cheap, you pang-alumni. Those exams, those difficult papers, those difficult researches can only make you better persons. The church and the university have a common treasure, the truth. And in our mission of telling the truth, four C's in a step-by-step process lead us to our goal. Confrontation, meaning we are ready to be treated as enemies, as liars, of liars, because we know we have a duty. Sa University of Pangasinan, bawal ang duwag. Sa University of Pangasinan, bawal ang sinungaling. Sa University of Pangasinan, lalong-lalo, bawal ang magnanakaw. How do we apply this to our present situation? Because UPang should be at the service of our community. My dear young people, when we were young, our source of information was the family and the school. And we were so sure about what our parents were teaching us and about what our teachers were teaching us. But times have changed. The family is no longer the only source, and the school is no longer the only source. We have some false teachers, like unethical social media, like liars on social media. And be critical. UPang does not train cheap students. UPang trains critical thinkers who will be transformers of society. Next week, we will celebrate the EDSA anniversary. Most of you were not there. Most of you were not born yet. But I can tell you with pride, young people of UPang, I was there. I was 25 years old. And I saw that the Philippines was at the brink of a civil war because the military against the military were at the brink of war. And what happened? The church, your church, stood in the middle. That is why we prevented a civil war. Look at what is happening in Myanmar. The continuation of the civil war continues to hurt people. Why? Because Myanmar does not believe in Christ. At EDSA 1986, the church, your church, stood in the middle and pursued peace. And now we are here. Do not be ashamed of EDSA 1986. Be proud of it. You know, my dear students, I have a niece who lives in the U.S. And after EDSA, they were asked by their teacher, "What do you want to be when you grow up?" Some said, "I want to be an astronaut. I want to be a movie star. I want to be the president of the USA. I want to be an inventor, I want to be a pilot, I want to be, and so on and so forth. There was one American boy who saw on television how we fought the dictatorship with rosaries and prayers, and there was no bloodshed. That American boy saw the story on CNN, and then when his teacher asked him, "What do you want to be when you grow up?" The American boy said, "When I grow up, I want to be a Filipino." EDSA was our moment of glory. No matter what the trolls tell you, no matter what the trial, what the liars tell you, believe me, I will not lie to you. I was there. And we stood against violence using prayer. We prevented civil war using our faith. And it was a revolution, but it was bloodless because of God in our midst. This is your mission now, my dear young people. Ask us elders to tell you the truth, but choose your teachers. Be critical teachers, be critical thinkers, and be careful with liars. Ulitin ko, sa yupang, bawal ang sinungaling. At huwag kayong sasama sa sinungaling. Sa yupang, bawal ang magnanakaw. At huwag kayong boboto sa mamamatay tao at magnanakaw. Sa yupang, bawal ang duwag. Kahit anong gawin nila sa atin, tell the truth all the time. Kung hindi ka maninindigan para sa totoo, kailan pa? Sino pa? The truth must be proclaimed in this university if we are to be faithful to our founders.